Well, welcome back and thanks for joining us today. I have Tonya Zierden with OLV with me this morning, and we are excited to talk about school. I know that the summer is coming to the kind of the last roundabout, and so we just want to start talking about that. We've got to get some school supplies for parents around the area, and so registration, are you accepting registration, and where do people go to do that?
We are accepting registration. They can call school, which is 736-6661 is our phone number, or they can also go to our website and download an application. Our website is www.ffolvschool.org.
Now, for those of you that don't know, OLV is Our Lady of Victory Church.
Yep.
And school. And so,
yep.
Do you have to be participating in the church, even though it's teaching Christ-centered preschool through sixth grade children, how to just have that moral and
background. It
yes.
really helps with that initial foundation, getting them started on the right foot. They're just sponges at that age, and being able to work with them and incorporate Christ and values at the primary age is just wonderful.
And I have to say, what a support for parents who are trying to really develop that at home as well. It's just that nice little backup to have that in a school curriculum as mm-hmm. well. Tell us a little bit about registration being open and that people can go on the website and download the application that way. They could certainly call. But let us know about class sizes. How many kids do you tend to have in a class?
K through six, we are right around 100 students, so we average just about 15 students per class.
Okay.
We have one classroom of each grade, and what we see, the biggest change that we see in students is in the fall. There isn't a lot of anxiety because they know the students are going to be in their class, they know who their teacher is going to be, and so all of that fear of that newness in the fall, there's still that excitement about a new room or, you know, moving downstairs with the big kids.
Right.
But there isn't as much anxiety about, will my friends be in my classroom? You know, who's my teacher going to be? How does the lunch line work? There's a lot less anxiety for our students. So.
And there are a lot of different options for parents as far as not only just tuition, but lunch programs and also transportation in the morning. A lot of us have to work mm-hmm. at certain times, and it's hard to get that transportation down, especially if you're close to the area. You know, a lot of times the buses will only run at a certain distance. And so what are some of the options with some of that?
So we share busing with the public school. So for our students that need to be transported to the bus, they transport just like the public school students. They go to the middle school, they resort into their building buses, and they come out to our school. We also offer before school childcare. We call it Kids Club. And so for parents that either the bus isn't an option or, you know, the timing isn't right, students can be dropped off as early as 7:30 at the school, and then we have a staff person there. They play, hang out, read, whatever they need to do in the morning. Some students are still feeling like they're waking up, so they just have some quiet time. And then we also serve hot breakfast on site. So if they need to have breakfast before they go off to their classroom, they can do that too. So
that is such a nice option for
yeah.
parents. Is that something that they have to register for, the kids camp or the kids club? Is that something that they need to be prepared for ahead of time?
We ask that they do register just so that if anything would happen, that we know exactly how to contact those parents. You know, we have the information in the office too, but so that it's on site in the gym with the students. And just also for scheduling, to make sure that we have enough room for the students that need to be there. There is an additional charge for that service in the morning. And then we also offer it after school too, from 3 o'clock when our students are dismissed until 5 o'clock. So, and that time they do have snack, they go outside. They do have a small window to do homework if need be. Most of the students don't have a ton of homework, or they're really just needing to unwind. For the most part, it's the younger students. Once they get a little bit older, they have activities or different things that they're involved in after school. So for the most part, after school, we see it mostly used by students in preschool through about fourth grade. It's just harder for daycare because you know, they're too old to be in daycare during the day, they're in school. So it's something that our families really appreciate.
Well, I can definitely relate myself. Having said that, I'm sure it helps with staffing when they pre-register as well. Yep. Give you a little bit of a heads up. And I know that within the schools, substitutes are needed highly. Is that something that OLV is also in need of?
Yep, we have a handful of really good subs, and we're very fortunate about that. One thing that subs don't realize is if they register with District 544, we use different sub pools. So just because they're on the sub list for the public school doesn't mean that we will necessarily have their contact information. So if people are interested in subbing, stop by the school office and fill out our application and get on our list, and then we actually call and line up. I think the public school does it a little bit different, but definitely we would love to have more quality subs. So
absolutely. Well, you have wonderful staff right now.
We do.
So if you can add to that, that's just a blessing in disguise.
Yes.
So talking about wonderful staff and how you don't have to be a part of the member program or attend OLV's church services and mass Sunday morning, let me know a little bit about tuition costs and what a parent would do. Are there different levels of financing available for parents, or is it just a straight cost? How does that work at OLV? Yep.
We have two different tuition plans, one for students that are attending that are members of our Catholic Church or a surrounding parish. And so tuition for them this year is $1,650. $1,650 for the year. Most of our families pay it in monthly, they break it down to 9 or 10 months. And then for students that are not members of our church or surrounding parish, tuition this year is $2,150, so $2,150. And part of the reason we can keep that tuition at a really manageable level is years ago we had some very insightful alumni realized that we needed to have an endowment program set up, so that they have worked very hard to get that endowment up over $1 million. And it's something that my predecessor, Sandy Carpenter, who retired a couple years ago, was very proud of, and rightly so. She worked very hard to make sure that money was put aside to help families that wanted this kind of education for their students. And to be able to take that concern off the table, to take that concern off their list of reasons why maybe they wouldn't send their student there. And so that has been such a gift for our school families that, some families get a scholarship 1 year and things are rough, whatever, they're going through some big things with their family, and then the next year they're able to budget it themselves. We have some students that get scholarships all their way through, and then the neat thing is then once they get through that really demanding phase of their life, a lot of them donate back. They realize the value that the education that their students got, and then also really appreciate the fact that someone before them, contributed so that they could benefit. And it's kind of that paying it forward, paying it backwards, working together. So it's a great asset for our school. And it really helps take that financial piece, that concern off the list for families. So it's great.
That is just wonderful. I love when people invest in the kids' education. Mm-hmm. So is there a place that anyone in the general public could go ahead and contribute to that fund, or is it something that's only within OLV?
Nope. We have parishioners, we have community members, we have people that move into the community that have just been supporters of private and or Catholic education in their home community. And you can send a check to the school, you can send a check to the church, and just mark it endowment fund.
Very nice.
Yep.
Well, definitely a lot of options and things happening at OLV and also in Fergus Falls. So again, just want to thank Tonya for joining us today from OLV, and thank you for being a member of our chamber.
Yes.
We really appreciate all of you over there, and for really investing in the kids these days. They need more love than ever before. So thank you for joining us today, and we'll be right back after a short break.